Hello everyone, in today's video I will discuss about documentary method in ethnomethodology of Garfinkel. Before explaining about documentary method, I shall also tell you what are the other concepts that needs to be discussed for understanding documentary method. Common shared knowledge of the social structure. This is a very important concept. This needs to be explained. So, in this video, I will first discuss about common shared knowledge of the social structure and then documentary method. But these are all interrelated concepts. So, let's begin. Documentary method is for whom? It is for the professional sociologist as well as for the common people. Common people also use documentary method, and professional sociologists also use documentary method, but for different purposes. Professional sociologist uses documentary method of ethnomethodology for exploring the underlying pattern of the society and how the common shared knowledge of the social structure is used in the common sense situation of choice. And common people uses it in their everyday life, in their everyday interaction and activities. So now come to the point. Common or shared knowledge of the social structure. So in this idea or this concept, two important things needs to be mentioned. One is common shared knowledge. Another one is common culture. There is common knowledge or shared knowledge among the members of the society, and another thing is common culture. Common culture here does not mean that one culture or single culture. No, common cultural entity in the society. I will give the example. And another thing is shared knowledge or common knowledge. So, social structure has these two important aspects, common culture and a shared knowledge. So, human beings or individual possesses these two important aspects, and social scientist or sociologist explores or discovers these two important aspects like common shared knowledge and common culture. Now, example of common culture: marriage, family. Here I am giving two important examples: marriage and family. These are two popular and widely accepted culture or cultural practice: family, marriage. In every society, these are practices. So, point here is that the way of practice, traditions, rituals, other various allied activities of family and marriage are not uniform, are not similar in all the societies. So, different societies have different traditions, cultures, rituals, and activities, but culture called family or marriage are prevalent in every society. So, social scientist tries to explore how the common cultural elements or common culture and common shared knowledge of the social structure both interlinked, and how human beings use these in their everyday life, and that ultimately contributes in the process of the social order. Now come to the point, what is common shared knowledge? Common shared knowledge is these aspects of the society or these aspects of the social structure which are essential for the living, which are essential for everyday activities. In the everyday activities, human beings do different activities different things, different performances, and for all these things there are various mechanisms, systems. So human beings have shared or common knowledge about all these things. Human beings are not confused or ambiguous in any situation. Human beings in any of the situation of their society understand what to act, what to do, what not to do, what to say, what not to say. Why? Because it is a commonly shared knowledge. And this common shared knowledge is again linked to the common sense situation of choice. Because common sense is important because it allows or ensures human beings or individuals to live or to act in an orderly way. Without common sense, there would be disorderly life, disorderly activity. So common sense situation and common shared knowledge, these are again linked. So human beings possesses the common sense, common shared knowledge of the social structure. There are, as I have said, numbers of elements of the social structure, numbers of attributes of the social structure, various aspects of the social structure. So all these structures are in the possession of the human beings. That is, human beings have the knowledge about all these things. So it is because they are doing in everyday life, and it is shared. Whatever one person do can be interpreted, understood by the opposite person, other person. Other person is doing, and another person is also getting, receiving, reciprocating. This is called common shared knowledge of the social structure. Now here point comes the documentary method. That is how documentary method works here. Documentary method basically uses for revealing or for exploring an underlying pattern behind all these things, behind all these common sense knowledge or common sense situations, common shared knowledge and other aspects. So here Garfinkel used Karl Mannheim's concept of documentary method. And documentary method for Mannheim means search for underlying pattern, search for underlying pattern of vast meanings. That is, there are numbers of meanings, numbers of the activities, numbers of actions, realities, cultures, practices, but one underlying pattern exists. So search for this underlying pattern. So documentary method basically search or investigate, explore this underlying pattern. Because of this underlying pattern, society maintains order, human beings are able to exchange with each other, human beings are able to share their common shared knowledge, human beings are able to act or able to communicate in the common sense situations, they are able to choose the common sense situation. It is because of the underlying pattern. Otherwise, there cannot be a social order. But this underlying pattern does not mean that everything is uniform in the society. No. There are numbers of societies. Numbers of societies have different, various way of practices, various way of activities, various meanings of a particular activity. But underlying pattern exists. And because of this underlying pattern, social order is maintained. So documentary method tries to understand this underlying pattern. And ethnomethodology has this documentary method, that is imbibed this documentary method for investigating, for exploring the social order and everyday life of the human beings. So I will explain further documentary method with the help of an example or experiment that being mentioned by Garfinkel in his book Studies in Ethnomethodology. But first I shall explain what is underlying pattern. Underlying pattern means a law of the society. Law of the society, here law does not means these rules. Here law means the common pattern, common entity, common the element that regulates the society. Suppose the nature has various laws, and because of various laws nature works and we are able to live in the society. Suppose the gravitation, the law of the changing day and night, law of changing season, all are naturally given. So here it means that there is a pattern, there is a fixed pre-given pattern of the maintaining the order in the world, in the natural system. So similarly, there is a common pattern mechanism or a system that maintains social order, that maintains order in the society, that maintains balance in the society. So from this underlying pattern, different societies expresses their own activities. So here individual documentation means the description of a particular society. Documentation here means description. So description of a particular society comes from the underlying pattern. So the description of a particular society or a particular society's existence is the proof that there is underlying pattern. Again, existence of various societies is the result of underlying pattern. So both reinforce each other. There is underlying pattern is the reason behind the existence of society. Again, the existence of society is the proof that there is underlying pattern. So underlying pattern has its evidence through the society, through various social practices, human beings' activities. And again, there is an underlying pattern, there is a proof that underlying pattern is there. How? Because of the social order in the society, because of the societal existence, societal processes, human beings' everyday activities in an orderly way in the society. So both underlying pattern and social practices or everyday life reinforce each other. So documentary method tries to reveal or explore this pattern of the society. This pattern is universal or universal. There may be different pattern, but point here is that the entire society is under a particular pattern, under a particular underlying pattern. So different societies may have variations, but it follows a particular pattern, it follows a particular mechanism. Because of this mechanism, this society is able to survive, society is able to manage its order. So there is a experiment conducted by Garfinkel. There is how the underlying pattern can be understood, how the common sense knowledge of the structure or common sense situation can be understood. So through his experiment we can have brief understanding of this. So in the next video I will continue this discussion, and you can also put your comment if you have anything to say. Thank you very much for watching.